doing?
Rainbow hair. Just a little bit of rainbow hair. Get all this paint out of here first. Lighten it up a bit.
Amazing.
Step number one.
Bleach?
The bleach.
Now, does this hurt?
You'll feel it working. Ready?
Yeah, ready. Yeah, it's starting to burn.
Almost there.
Got the bag. Step two, the rinse.
Which shades of the rainbow we want to use on your head?
Just a few colors.
All the shades of blue.
Yeah, it's basically like a month-long performance that I'm doing.
Gotta be getting character somehow.
Yeah, exactly. Whose idea was this?
Perfect little unicorn.
Made it to Ottawa for our residency. Gonna be here at Sussex Contemporary all month long in our nation's capital.
So here we are. It's the Home Depot life.
Home Deeps.
Got like all this stuff. I'm breaking the bank here.
Drill, paper towels, stir sticks, mixing containers. Can't even see everything. I got a lot of stuff. Drop cloth, staple gun, stir sticks, more staples, wet paint signage, string, sandpaper. D-rings and all my paint.
Got all my stuff here. Roslyn's here working hard, getting everything ready.
So for this show, every canvas is gonna be circular. Here, these are the components for the arena. We're gonna do another dome. It's on the floor there, just resting. Everything's coming together,
ready to go. It's gonna be crazy.
Universal color for everyone to see, to enjoy. I'm super excited. Thank you for tuning in. Thank you for following my vlogs. And also just thank you for being you. All you artists out there, continue to be you. Thank you for all your love and support. I love you all. Thank you so much. Sponsored. Woo-hoo! Got 65 gallons of paint and I'm going to be pouring them in this arena over here for my brand new show. Time to mix up the paint.
4:12 a.m. The space is now quite painted up. And so am I.
It's pitch black outside.
It's 6:30 a.m. now, sun is out. Day one of painting, I'm super exhausted. It's like 7 in the morning, haven't slept. So I'm gonna get out of here, get a few hours of sleep, and come back and do it all again.
Whoa.
Will you take part in my life?
Super
exhausted.
Failed painting, didn't work out. 4 or 5 like failed paintings, and eventually I just got so frustrated with the fact that they weren't working that I blacked it all out and then went fresh with like all the colors. This happened, but then underneath all of the other paintings came up in the air bubbles, kind of a whole galaxy of color inside this piece. Very stoked about this piece. Within the confines of like these parameters, so that's why I like to share it, because it's not just like, it's not always easy.
Yeah.
getting real worked in. I'm standing on top of a bunch of containers of paint. I'm actually going through it. I want to show you something. This piece over here, extremely stoked about. I think this is the best painting that I've ever made. This painting to me gives me the feeling, a combination of like being very small and insignificant and being overwhelmed by space. Combination of like looking up into the stars and feeling like you're tiny, and also looking up in the stars and just realizing how large everything is. It's relational, like size on a molecular level and then on like a cosmic level. I don't know why, but I feel like this piece does that for me. Really happy about that. These ones I made today, still drying, heavy production here, a lot more to go. Day two of painting, getting a little exhausted, it's been very productive. We're right on the street here, it's like Friday night, and people just keep on like walking by and stuff, checking it out. My whole zone is like right here. We're tired, we're exhausted. We're gonna keep on making rainbows. You know it. Upgrade the trough, this larger size. And we're gonna do a big painting. Check it out. Very, very close. He is not yet satisfied. Scrape away all his hard earned paint. He knows no limit to perfection. We'll be right back.
So I'm a little over breath. Let's do this one more time. Final stretch here, covered in paint. I've completed 30 paintings. I've been really hustling. Now, the piece de resistance is here. The dome, notoriously difficult for me. It's been a heavy, heavy paint usage. It's early in the morning, late nights. I've been painting all day. Instagram, Facebook, emailing, IRL, or Skype.
In your process, just do what you feel is right in your heart.
So it's like, it's crazy. It's crazy busy. And hopefully this one works out. Let's see. Feeling good about this one. Intense. Spencer's here, polarizing gels.
So you remove 100% of the reflections.
Okay, so all the works are done. But now, the cleanup. We've got the spinner in its crate. The waste is ridiculous. Like, this has gotta change. It's all trash, it's kinda nasty. Okay, let's go. Cleanup went well. Now, did a few more pieces today for the media preview. He's going during the opening. For all those haters out there, let's say a 5-year-old can do it. Well, have at her, go for it. Fantastic spinner for all the haters and for the kids. I do it for the kids. The whole arena is all stacked up over there. That's a wrap. My uncle showed up to the show here in Ottawa. He's from Ottawa. He hasn't seen it since I've taken it from him.
And so I've been using this for 9 years, and he's gonna see what I did with his bike.
It's your bike!
There it is, here it is! It's your bike!
Does it still spin?
Hell yeah.
It works.
I've been using it for like 9 years.
It works.
One gear, no brakes.
No brakes.
I mean, there's two answers. One is a lifetime. But yeah, it takes a few minutes.
Yeah. A few minutes?
Yeah.
To do one?
Yeah.
But you don't know what you're gonna get.
I don't know what I'm gonna get.
My
success ratio is like, on a good day, is like 50-50. Like, it works, it doesn't work. Yes. It's like kind of like a coin toss. Totally hands off. Controlled chaos. I was here all month doing it. Everything here was done live. But this is actually the birthplace of this machine, because I got this bicycle here. Fred and I came here to do a renovation. Brought the bike back to Toronto. Arts University. OCAD, yeah. An assignment where you can do whatever you want. I'm looking around and I'm seeing everyone approach the canvas in a similar way. They got their palette, they got their brush, they got their easel, and they start to try to make an image look like an image. I saw an opportunity to do something different. Got a potter's wheel, started to spin it around just to be different. This bike came back to Toronto and my friend was riding around. He locked it up on a bike post, power smashed into it. My friend was fine, just like, but the bike got like twisted around. It was a bummer. I was like, you know what? Let's make it into art. Let's change this. Let's change the way we're thinking about this. And I welded what you see now here. And since then, it hasn't been back to Ottawa, so it's round trip now.
Show's over. Got out of Home Depot. I catched up all my moving supplies. I'm moving the whole show to Toronto in a 36-foot U-Haul. Circus moves on. Look at this stress right now. My whole forehead's all crinkled up. Here we go with the load up. All the work packaged up. Spinner.
And that is a wrap. Get it that time?
You got it.
Lil Pump. Driving to Toronto, all my art in there, back on the highway. Boom, pop up here, pop up there. Montreal, Toronto, Ottawa. What you want? What's next? Going to LA, Joseph Gross Gallery, do another residency there. Ooh, see it with your own eyes. All right, Toronto, let's get it. What's good, YouTube? That is the end of this episode. Thank you for tuning in. I hope you enjoyed it. Please remember to like, comment, subscribe, let me know how I can improve these vlogs. If you liked it, give it a share, hit subscribe.
Join the notification squad.
Peace.